गुड मॉर्निंग फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू आवर जनरल क्लास। स्टडे वी लर्न अबाउट द नेचर ऑफ बिजनेस। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न अबाउट द ऑब्जेक्टिव ऑफ बिजनेस, व्हाई पीपल डू बिजनेस। सो ऑब्जेक्टिव ऑफ बिजनेस इज द फर्स्ट वन इज इकोनॉमिक ऑब्जेक्टिव। एज वी नो दैट ऑल द ह्यूमन बीइंग्स दे डू इकोनॉमिक एक्टिविटीज फॉर देयर लाइवलीहुड, एंड व्हाट दे डू बेसिकली दे डू गुड्स एंड सर्विसेस। Some people they produce the goods. Someone like in any of those they do. They are doing selling we can say wholesale, retail. Then mostly people they earn by their selling their goods or producing their goods. The second activity is the people do services like we can say doctors, engineers, teachers. They do services like lawyers. What they do? So all the people they do economic activities. They are earning by dealing their two things. One, like they dealing the goods, or other people they do services. So by these means people earning their for their livelihood. So today we will learn the objective of the business. What is the objective of business? The first objective is like economic objective, the earning profit. First important objective of the business is to make profit, and that is earning profit. That is all the business what they want to do. They want to make the profit maximization. They want this is the first objective. If you not make the profit, your company cannot run, and you will have problem. You cannot you need a lot of resources, fixed assets. You need very good cost. You need for the salary and all. So what you need? So you have to make the profit. This is the first objective of the company. And the second objective is some business what they do. They do market standing. Market standing means if you are making profits. If you are not making profit, you are investing in the business. That means your business is growing, it's expanding. Expanding means market is standing. Your market is increasing, your customer is increasing, or like market share is increasing. That means your business is growing and expanding in that form. That is for the market expanding. This is the second objective. First objective is profit maximization. You make the profit. If you are not able to make profit, what initial period, what you want to do? You want to do the market standing. You increase your market by expanding your business. The third objective is innovation. Some company what they do innovations, like they bring changes in the products, yeah, means of productions. They bring changes in that one. So they do research and development. They invest on that one. So that money also invested. So that is the also value addition for the company. So company new products will launch. So company will earn their profit that one. So in that area also innovation is also like objective of the company. If you are having company, then physical and financial resources you must have. That means you need like a factory, layout should be like people can see that one. You need the offices, you need the corporate offices. So these resources should, you should invest that one. So your physical means people can see, yeah, this is the showroom of the company, this is the factory of the company, this is the outlet of the company, this is the offices of the company. So all the things you should invest that one. So some company they do investing in that areas. So people can know about the company. The fifth object is productivity. Productivity means like enhance the use. What you want to do? Like the resources you are utilizing, that should be productive, and that should be like you can make profit from that. That should be like resources what you input you are doing. So you are getting more from the inputs, and your output is more than input. That's called productivity. So the sixth objective is managers development. So all the company what they do, they hire the people, and they managers they lead about the company, and they make all the decisions. So your manager should be capable, and manager development should be always there. So what company they do training and development for the managers. So there is a new techniques and decision making they do, and they lead to the company in efficiently and effectively manners. The seventh objective is workers' performance. The company like employees are also part of the company. So employee would be efficient, then your company will grow, our productivity will be better. So what company they can do? The workers' performance should be better. The training and development program they always do, and their working environment everything should be good. So the company and about the employees, their performance they can increase by the changing the attitudes. So all the employees they can think about and working for the company, and companies take care output will be better. So here we have been that this is the objective of the economic objectives. So all the company what they do, this is the objective of the business. First is the first objective of the company is earning profit. If you not make profit, you cannot sustain the market. The second objective we have seen here, the market standing. You should increase your like market shares. Market share your customer should increase in the market. You can like expand your business in the market. Innovations, you should expand on the innovations, new product, new means of production, you should use that. And physical and financial resources, you should invest that. Like your showroom, your factory, you should be good to manage. Productivity, whatever resources you are utilizing that should be productive. And managers development, who is the leading, the top manager, they should be smart enough to lead the company properly. So managers training and development should be there. So the company should invest in these areas so they can grow the company faster. The workers' performance, like employee attitude should be positive. So they are working in a team, they can achieve their targets and company can go into long run. So here we have seen that. So the other factor is there is some also like social objective of the business also. So what they want to do? So social objective, we can say the ideal customer, they need the good quality products. So they should provide the good quality products. And these things should be fair and they should treat the employees in the best manner. And sociology also, like they can provide more jobs to the people in the society. So these are the social objectives, we can say that. And then all the business we have, so here we will learn about the risk. So we know that in the business, there is risk. So the business is totally dependent upon like risk. There will be more risk, no risk, no gain. So in the business, this policy always the risk is, there has to be some kind of risk here. One is a speculative risk. A speculative means what people can do. They can speculate about what could be the situation in the markets, like about the demand and supply. They should speculate and they can maybe sell that one. And the second is pure risk. Pure risk means it can happen and not happen, but they take the risk. And for the risk covers, what they will do? By taking insurance and all the things. So in the business, the speculative risk means it can be lost, yeah, it can be lost again. In the pure risk, like you can say that say fire, these are pure risk. So there are these kind of causes of risk basically. There were causes of natural risk, like flood can come, earthquake can come, like famine can come. These are natural risks for the business. Human risk, something can happen, like mishandling by the humans, like fire, stolen goods, these things can be happened by the human beings. If logging, like due to demand and supply, some changes in the market, due to this, there are risks also economic. Another causes, like a strike, a lockdown, these are also of the causes of the business risk. So in the business, there is no risk, no gain. So all the businessmen, what they do, they take the risk and they get the profit for that. So in this module, we have learned there objective of the business. Objective of the first important objective is earning profit. Market standing, innovation, physical and financial resources, productivity, manager development and workers' performance. Here we have discussed about the causes of this. You will go through that one and you will read from the book as well in more details. Okay, have a nice day.